Let me write another example on non-exact differential equation, that is taking the difference between two partial derivatives, and it will be divided by m, the value of coefficient of dy from the given differential equation, and then how this problem can be tackled, and then a solution we can write later. Another two methods we can study, that is rule 3 and rule 4. In this problem, now we will study by taking the difference between m with respect to y and n with respect to x.
Example, solve x into y cube plus of y dx, and plus of, it is 2 into x square y square plus x plus y cube, sorry, it is y to the power of 4 and dy equal to 0.
In this problem also, we will write the differentiation by taking m with respect to y and n with respect to x, then we will take the difference between these two partial derivatives.
According to this problem, this is m dx plus of n dy equal to 0.
We will collect the values of m and n from this.
Let m is equal to, that is this value, x into y cube plus of y implies del m divided by del y is equal to 3 times x into y square and plus of 1. And
n is the coefficient of dy. The total quantity which acts as a coefficient of dy, we will collect that as n function of, that is x comma y.
That is n is equal to 2 times x square y square plus x plus y to the power of 4. This implies del n divided by del x,
del n by del x we collect.
So from this, with respect to x means y is constant, and here this was done with respect to y, 3x into y square plus 1, but here that is 2 times with respect to x, 2 times means 4 times, 4 times x into y square, and with respect to x means this is 0 and minus of 2, sorry, that is 2, and then minus of 2 after taking the difference. Anyway, these two values are not same. This implies del m divided by del y is not equal to, it is del n by del x.
So what do you conclude here about this comparison?
This implies equation 1. This is equation 1. ODE 1 is non-exact.
Given ordinary differential equation is said to be non-exact, then
we find the value or difference between these two. Afterwards, we will think of by which value it is suitable to divide. Okay, let del m divided by del y minus del n divided by del x, that is del m by del y means 3x into y square plus of 1 minus 4xy square and minus of 2, because this minus sign is to be multiplied for both the terms. Then this is equal to minus x into y square plus 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. This is minus of x into y square and
plus 1, minus of x into y square plus 1, because I have written that minus sign outside the bracket.
Then, so this term can be cancelled from this one, but not from this one. because when you consider this y, you can take common, leaving the coefficient inside, x into y square and plus of 1 after taking y outside. Then let 1 divided by m of del m divided by del y minus, it is del n by del x, that is equal to 1 by m is 1 divided by, I am taking y outside here itself, y into, that is x into y square plus 1 into minus of, it is x into y square and plus 1. So this term can be cancelled and finally we are getting minus 1 by y, minus 1 by y, which is divided by difference divided by m, and this is equal to function of y alone.
That means it is free from x when we divide from the value m. Therefore,
we multiply we find the integrating factor. Is equal to I f equal to e to the power minus, that is f of y, it is dy. E to the power minus, minus 1 by y, it is dy. It is e to the power log y is the integration. Minus into minus plus,
integration of 1 divided by y dy, you are getting it as log y.
Therefore, e to the power log y we are getting, the answer is y only,
because e to the power log x is equal to only x from the logarithm formula.
Then we multiply this integrating factor.
For what purpose? We multiply this integrating factor to the given differential equation to convert the differential equation into exact differential equation. Earlier, that differential equation was said to be non-exact, and it will be converted to exact on the multiplication of this symbol.
Therefore, equation 1 into IF implies, that is y, 1 by y, that is y into this much. So, x into y to the power of 4 plus y square after multiplying by y, it is dx plus of 2 into x square, it is y cube, and x into y plus y to the power of 5, it is dy equal to 0. Then you can also verify,
at this stage you can also verify whether this equation is converted to exact differential equation or not.
Therefore, this is the value of m. You can consider del m by, it is del y. So, del m by del y is equal to, with respect to y, means 4 times x into y cube plus 2y, and del n divided by del x is equal to 4 times x into y cube, with respect to x means, that is plus of, it is 2y. So, both the values are same. What do you conclude? This implies exact differential equation. That means equation 2. 2 is exact differential equation. This is equation 2.
When once it is converted to exact differential equation, you can write the solution directly by integrating every term.
Now, solution of 2 is given by, solution of 2 is given by, first term,
that is integration of m. Okay, what is that?
This term, x into y cube plus y is constant and plus of terms free from x. Terms free from x means this is on multiplication, equation number 2, x into y to the power of 4 and y square, and terms free from x. Terms free from x means integration. This is y to the power of 5 dy equal to constant.
Now you have to integrate term by term. This term by term, when you integrate, you will be getting the solution of the differential equation.
Therefore, with respect to x, keeping y as constant, x square into y to the power of 4 divided by 2 plus of x into y square plus of y to the power 6 divided by 6 is equal to c. So this is the solution for non-exact differential equation in the rule number 2.
Rule number 1, we have divided, that is 1 by n into this difference. Rule number 2, 1 by m, in any number you can call it, either 1 or 2, but when once m is divided for the difference, m is divided, then you will be getting function of y alone, and n is divided, you will be getting function of x alone. Then corresponding integrating factors you have to calculate. So now I will move on to the next rule, where the equation is supposed to be, given equation is supposed to be homogeneous, and in that case homogeneous, how this type of differential equation is to be solved and what is the procedure to solve that type of differential equation, we will see that. Now
the next rule I will write, because all the problems I am writing in the mixed form, already we have discussed separately. Example: solve dy by dx x cube plus y cube and divided by, it is x into y square.
Dy by dx is equal to x cube plus y cube divided by x into y square. Even by homogeneous method also, by taking substitution as y equal to vx and dy is equal to v into dx plus x into dv, that also you can apply. Or x equal to vy, then it takes dx is equal to v into dy plus y into dv. Then also it can be reduced to the separation of variables form. But here, this is non-exact differential equation, but we are solving with the condition that the coefficients of dx and dy must be having same degree throughout. When it is homogeneous, then the integrating factor is given by like this. But let us verify first of all the derivatives after resetting the problem. That means rewriting the problem in the form of m dx plus n dy is equal to 0.
Let us write this problem in that order. Let dy, cross multiplication, that is m dx, x into y square, it is dx, minus of x cube, minus of x cube plus y cube, that is plus of, you can write minus, and then dy equal to 0. You can take your cross multiplication, x into y square, x into y square, it is dy, sorry, this is dy and this is dx. Okay, so let me write plus sign for the first term, that is x cube plus y cube into dx, and minus of x into y square, it is dy equal to 0. And retaining this plus sign in between, x cube plus y cube plus of, it is dx, plus of minus x into y square, it is dy equal to 0.
Because in between we must have plus sign, When we compare with the standard differential equation, that is m dx plus n dy is equal to 0.
This is similar to m dx plus n dy
equal to 0. M dx plus n dy is equal to 0.
Now, m is equal to x cube plus y cube implies del m by del y.
And for this rule, third rule application, always the given differential equation must be of homogeneous type.
Then del m by del y,
even any other method you can apply in case if it works. If it is going to be allowed, if it is going to be supporting to give the solution. But in the rule 3, we need to expect the given statement of the problem should be of homogeneous differential equation.
That's what I am discussing. Then, with respect to y means 3y square and n is equal to minus x into y square, that is del n divided by del x, that is minus of y square.
So, del m by del y is 3y square and del n by del x is
minus of
y square. Both the values are not same. Hence,
it is said to be
what kind of differential equation? It is said to be non-exact differential
equation. Non-exact ODE. So, non-exact ODE, then we need to take this differential equation
for finding the integrating factor of this kind.
Then we find the integrating factor as IF equal to 1 divided by m into x plus of n into y. So according to this, what is m
and what is n, already we have discussed.
So then you write accordingly, that is 1 divided by m into x. So m is this value, this is x cube plus y cube. Okay, for that x is to be multiplied. So y cube into x and plus of here, this is to be multiplied by, that is x cube plus y cube plus y cube and n into y. So n into y means this is minus of y into y square into, that is y square into y means y cube. So this will be that is equal to 1 divided by x to the power of 4 plus y cube minus of, that is y cube, this is x into y cube. So this is integrating factor. Now
you must multiply this integrating factor to the given differential equation so that it must become exact, then we can write the solution.
So given differential equation, that is x cube plus y cube into dx and minus of x into y square, it is dy is equal to 0. Multiply this with that integrating factor, that is multiplying by IF. So what you can write, multiplying by IF means this can be IF is equal to, that is 1 x cube multiplying by IF to this differential equation. So directly you can write for this differential equation x cube plus y cube divided by x to the power of 4 plus x into y cube minus of y cube. This is dx, okay, this is dx, and plus or minus of x into y square whole divided by x to the power of 4 plus x into y cube minus of y cube, that is dy equal to 0. So if you differentiate this, these two terms, and these two terms must give the exact differential equation condition to be satisfied. Afterwards, the usual procedure you will apply. That usual procedure will be to write the first term integration, okay, treating that y as constant, and second term integration, terms free from x. No term free from x, you can write it as 0. Only this part needs to be integrated, that is x cube plus y cube divided by x to the power of 4 plus x into y cube minus y cube. This may be done with respect to the substitution method, and then you can solve this differential equation. Let me take another example of the same type. Solve x into dy by dx plus of y square by x equal to y. X into dy by dx plus y square divided by x equal to y is there. Let us verify whether this differential equation is said to be exact or non-exact differential equation. First of all, you have to write in the form of m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. M into dx plus n into dy is equal to 0. Let us rearrange this problem according to that type. Therefore, let x into dy by dx equal to y minus y square divided by x, x into y minus of y square, and whole divided by x is there. X is the LCM, x into y minus y square divided by x is there. Here x is there. So x into dy by dx, x into dy by dx is equal to xy minus y square divided by x is there. If you take cross multiplication and writing all terms to one side, this implies x into y minus y square, that is dx, and minus of x square dy is equal to 0, or x into y minus y square dx plus of minus x square dy equal to 0. So this will be like m dx plus of n dy equal to 0. It can be compared with the standard form of the differential equation. Let me write this one. That is m equal to xy minus of y square. Then this implies del m divided by del y. Del m divided by del y is equal to, with respect to y, you have to differentiate. That is x minus, it is 2y, and n is this value. N is minus of x square. Minus x square, this implies del n divided by del x is equal to minus of, it is 2x. Therefore, this clearly implies non-exact. It is not the exact differential equation. That is equation number 1. Which equation? This is the equation number 1. Okay. So now it is homogeneous. It is homogeneous. That comes in rule 3.
when we consider the integrating factor to convert this non-homogeneous into homogeneous form.
Then, since it is homogeneous, then the integrating factor is given by IF equal to 1 divided by M into X plus N into Y. M into X plus N into Y,
that becomes the integrating factor which will help us to convert non-exact into the
exact differential equation. Therefore, 1 by MX plus of NY is equal to, we will consider that one as 1 divided by M into X. So, X square Y minus Y square and plus of means here this is X square Y and minus is there already, that is minus of X square into Y is the integrating factor. But simplification is possible, divided by X square Y minus Y square minus of X square Y. Therefore, this one and this one will cancel, minus 1 by Y square. Okay. That is minus 1 by Y square, this is the term remains, that becomes the integrating factor. Then equation 1 into integrating factor gives equation 1 into integrating factor gives, that is the integrating factor. What is the integrating factor? That is minus 1 by Y square. Okay. That is M into X plus N into Y. So, M into X means that is XY. So, that minus 1 by Y square should be M into X. That should be M into X, X square Y minus Y square, and that is plus of this one. Okay. Then 1 by Y square, Y square minus XY, it is DX, and plus of minus 1 by Y square, that is into X square, it is dy equal to 0. Then minus of 1 plus of x divided by y, 1 y cancels, this is dx, and minus x square divided by it is y square, and dy equal to 0. Then integrate it. Integrating. We claim that this becomes the exact differential equation. Del m by del y means minus x by y square, and del n by del x means 2y, 2x divided by y square. That is x square divided by y square is there. Del n by del x is 2, and this is 1 by y square, and then y square cancels, and x divided by y square, 1y cancels. So minus, that is 2 divided by something. Okay. So then integrating factor, integrating each term, that is with respect to y, x you have to integrate, keeping y as constant, that is minus of x and plus of that is with respect to x base plus of x square divided by y, and terms not containing x, that is plus constant is equal to c1. Therefore, minus x plus x square and then y is equal to c. So this will be the solution. Like this, third rule can be applied.
Then we'll move on to the next rule, that is rule number 4. Here also I will choose directly the question. So through the question I will try to explain that rule number 3.
Solve xy into sine of xy plus of cos xy, it is dx, and plus of xy into sine xy minus cos of xy, cos of xy, and multiplied by, this is x, this is multiplied by y dx, and this is dy equal to 0.
This problem also you can verify for exact differential equation condition, that is not going to be satisfied, then we will declare this equation as non-exact differential equation.
So we will solve this problem as by assuming, that is by comparing this problem with the standard form
that comes in rule number 4.
Okay, what is that rule number 4? Here, y into, this implies y into f1 of xy dx plus x into f2 of xy dy equal to 0. If this is the type of differential equation, then other than those three types already we studied, if this is the type, then the integrating factor is given by, integrating factor is given by 1 divided by m into x minus n into y. This is what the integrating factor.
Integrating factor we are finding to convert the non-exact differential equation into exact differential equation.
Okay. This is totally m value, and you have to multiply that by x, and n value, this is totally n value, and you have to multiply this value by y. After multiplying, if you take in that way, that is 1 divided by m into x minus n into y, that gives 1 divided by 2 into xy, that is cos of xy. This is what you are getting.
Write that and simplify, because already this type of problem you have solved.
And you will be getting finally, this is the integrating factor. Now, if you write this equation as 1, then multiply IF to equation 1 to get 1 as exact ODE.
Equation 1 as exact differential equation.
Therefore, that exact differential equation, by multiplying the integrating factor, that integrating factor is, this is the value, 1 divided by 2 xy into cos xy. So multiply to each term, that is y is there, you take that y also inside, that is x into y square sine first term, this one, sine xy divided by 2xy, it is cos xy plus of y into it is cos xy divided by 2 times xy cos xy should be dx, and plus of this is xy by taking x inside, that is x square y sine xy and divided by 2 x into y cos xy and minus of second term multiplied by x cos of xy and whole divided by 2 times xy, it is cos of xy, this is multiplied by d1 equal to 0. So before going to the next step, that means you have to simplify to the possible extent. Now here sine by cos it will remain as it is, one y term will cancel and x term will cancel, and here y term will cancel, that is here y is there and denominator x remains, okay. And then after this one y term, then it is 1 by x, okay. Then in the second term, here y cancels, 1 x cancels, right, and here x cancels and x cancels, okay, right, and cos also here cancels, here cos also cancels. Then here this becomes in the bracket, 1 y remains, y by 2 sine by cos means tan xy, sine by cos means tan xy, and here cos cancels, 1 divided by 2x plus of 1 by it is 2x remains. Then it is dx, and the second term here 1x remains and denominator 2 remains. This sine by cos means that is also tan xy, tan xy, and here minus of it is 1 divided by 2y, that is dy equal to 0. So now I claim that you can verify after in your leisure time, this I claim that it is an exact differential equation, because every non-exact differential equation, when it is multiplied by the corresponding integrating factor depending on the nature of the problem, that is converted to exact differential equation. Now at this stage I claim this step gives the exact differential equation condition to be satisfied. Okay, that part you can verify. Now y by 2 tan xy plus 1 by 2x dx, and x by 2 tan xy minus of 1 by 2y, this is to be integrated, that is solution of this differential equation is to be written. Now solution is given by you have to write integration, that is y by 2 tan xy and plus of 1 divided by 2x dx, here y is constant, and plus of it is x divided by 2, that is tan xy, x into tan xy and x divided by 2. So and this becomes second term, that is minus of 1 divided by to y. Under integration, it is dy is equal to constant terms free from x. Terms free from x in the second part. So terms free from x from the second part means this term we cannot consider. So this term contains x, therefore we have to ignore this term. Then you will be having, that is y divided by 2 tan of xy and plus 1 divided by this 2x dx and plus of under integration minus 1 divided by 2y, it is dy is equal to constant. Now you integrate assuming that y is a constant. So tan xy integration is log, that means y by 2 as is, then log secant xy and whole divided by y.
Tan x is log secant x, but in place of x, x into y is there, where y is constant, that comes in the denominator.
And this is plus of 1 by 2, it is log x, and this is minus 1 by 2, should be log y, is equal to constant. So all the three are in terms of log function.
You can also simplify further,
otherwise you leave this itself as
your final answer. So like this, this is the last rule, that is rule number 4, what we discussed. Now I shall give few examples on this and then I shall move on to the linear differential equation. Okay, one of the examples I will write for your extra practice in this, in these three methods. Okay.
Solve the following, I will write. Solve the following. First example, x cube y square plus of x into dx plus of x square y cube minus y dy equal to 0.
This you have to check. How this is possible, like whether it is an exact or non-exact. When it is said to be exact, when it is said to be non-exact, and you can verify the differentiation values by taking del m by del y is equal to del n by del x, whether it is going to be satisfied or not.
Next example, that is y into x plus y plus 1 dx and plus of x into, it is x plus 3y and plus 2 dy equal to 0. Here also you take this y inside and then you check that differentiation del m by del y, and the you take this x inside and check the differentiation, that is del n by del x.
If those two values are same, you name it as exact and write the solution. If it is not same, then you need to write the procedure, which rule is going to be applied.
Next one. Three xy minus 2 into a into y square, this is dx, and plus of x square minus 2 into a into xy, it is dy equal to 0. So like this, some more problems you can find, but at least these samples you can try on your own and see that what experience you are going to get, whether it comes in rule 1 or rule 2 or rule 3 or rule 4.
Now the next topic is Bernoulli's differential equation. So Bernoulli's differential equation
is the equation said to be non-linear differential equation. So
So Bernoulli's differential equation is said to be non-linear, but before that you have to understand or you have to recall linear differential equation what you studied. When once it is said to be linear differential equation, then what is the solution that you have to identify? Okay, and what type of linear differential equation you have to arrange? Suppose the problem is appeared of what type, then what is the integrating factor? And afterwards the integrating factor, how it is going to help in writing the solution. So what is the meaning of linear differential equation?
First of all, let us discuss what is the definition of linear differential equation. Linear ODE. Actually Bernoulli is non-linear. Non-linear, it is ODE.
But you start with the differential equation by defining the linear one first, and then you go to the non-linear differential equation.
So linear differential equation takes the meaning linear ODE. That means the dependent variable. The dependent variable and its differential coefficient appear with first degree and they should not be multiplied together. This is the condition. This is what the definition of
differential equation, which is said to be linear. That means
the dependent variable and its differential coefficient. For example, dependent variable in the differential coefficient, that is dy by dx, is y is a function of x.
In that, dependent variable is y and x is called as independent variable.
Therefore, the dependent variable y and its differential coefficient appear with first degree
and they should not be multiplied together. Such a differential equation we call it as linear, otherwise it is called non-linear differential equation.
Okay, that means y into dy should not be appeared if y is a dependent variable.
Okay, so what is the standard form of differential equation linear that we let us define?
Standard form of linear ODE. Standard form of linear ODE means dy by dx plus of dy by dx plus of p of x into y is equal to q of x. So this is linear in y. This is linear in y means first degree of y. This is called linear differential equation with first degree of y having the derivative dy by dx form. Then how to solve this linear differential equation? The integrating factor you have to calculate. So integrating factor is equal to alpha equal to e to the power integral, that is px should be dx, e to the power integral px dx. So linear in y, that means first degree in y, then if is equal to e to the power px into dx. Solution, how to solve this? Then dependent variable into integrating factor is equal to integral q of x into if, that is q of x, that is this is x and then you have to write dx,
plus constant. This is the procedure to solve the linear differential equation.
If it is linear in y, if the given differential equation is said to be linear in x, then
you have to interchange x and y for all these three steps, and then you have to understand. If it is linear in y, that is first degree,
that is first degree in y, this is a linear differential equation, having the derivative dy by dx, having the y with first degree, and having the terms on the right side is free from y, that is called linear differential equation.
Then, if it is linear in x, then dx divided by dy, dx by dy, you interchange x and y, p of y into x is equal to q of y. This is said to be linear in y, sorry, linear in x. Then the integrating factor, then the integrating factor is given by, integrating factor is given by IF equal to e to the power integral, it is p of y into, it is dy, p of x into dx when it was linear in y. Here it is linear in x, x degree 1. You have to treat this as differential equation is linear in x.
Then solution. Solution. That solution is x into IF, because x is your dependent variable and y is independent variable, equal to integration, that is q of y into IF, that is dy instead of dx because y is left, and plus constant. So this is what the solution for linear differential equation.
So let me solve on this basis how the linear differential equation is to be solved using this procedure, that means by finding the integrating factor. Let me solve one example on this.
Example, solve cos square x dy by dx plus y is equal to tan x. This is your problem. Problem will not be given in the standard form of the linear differential equation. It may be given in any of the different type, but you have to rearrange that problem into according to your required form.
Now, so y into dy should not be there. Here y into dy means whether it may be cos y or simply y or sin y or tan y, e to the power y. Y into dy, if it is there, then you go for dx by dy form. But here dy is not multiplied by any of the terms of y. Therefore, it should be linear in y only. Therefore, you must write dy by dx, but with the absence of this coefficient. So, we will rewrite the problem. In the solution, so divide throughout by that is cos square x, divide throughout by, you have to remove this cos square x, then divide by dx, and plus of 1 divided by, it is cos square x, and it is y is equal to tan x, divided by, it is cos square x. So that is dy by dx, and this can be taken as dy by dx
plus of p of x into y is equal to q of x. It is of that type. That is y degree is 1 and this value happens to be the value of p of x. Therefore, it is linear. It is linear in y. It is linear in y. Then integrating factor you have to calculate. So integrating factor is equal to e to the power integral p of x into dx. E to the power integral 1 divided by cos square x, it is dx.
So what is the integration of cos square x in the denominator? That can be taken as secant square x.
That is e to the power integral, it is secant square x into dx. What is secant square x integration? E to the power, it is tan x. So e to the power tan x, integration of secant square x dx is equal to tan x. E to the power tan x is the value of integrating factor. Then equation 1, this if you call it as equation 1, so 1 into, then the solution of 1, is given by y into if is equal to integral qx into if dx plus constant. So y into if is y into e to the power, it is tan x equal to e to the power tan x into, that is right side, this is tan x, okay, and divided by it is cos square x and then dx plus constant. Now we have to integrate this term. So for this integration, this is tan x is there and this is tan x is there, and 1 by cos square means this is equal to secant square x. That is integration e to the power tan x into secant square x into tan x, that is dx. Put tan x, substitution method you can write, put tan x equal to t secant square x dx equal to dt. So with this substitution you solve the integration. So that gives, with this substitution, that is y into e to the power tan x is equal to y into e to the power tan x is equal to, what is that value? So y into e to the power tan x, here substitution, integral e to the power t secant square x into dx is equal to dt, and in place of tan x you can put it as t, that is dt plus constant. You do it integration by parts. First function e to the power t minus differentiation is 1 into twice integration e to the power t plus constant. This is y into e to the power, it is tan x. So this is equal to you have to leave the answer in terms of the given symbol. So this is tan x e to the power tan x minus e to the power tan x and plus constant. So y into e to the power, it is tan x. So this is the solution.
This is a sample I have given on the linear differential equation, and afterwards I shall discuss by applying this concept to the non-linear differential equation by reducing to the linear differential equation. As per the syllabus, Bernoulli's differential equation is supposed to be the non-linear. So we will reduce that non-linear into linear form.